everyone. Welcome to Mrs. Brevenise's math class. Today we're going to look at two lessons, lessons 5.6 and 5.10. I combined the addition and subtraction of decimals because they're very similar. So our objective today is I will be able to add and subtract decimals. Get out your notebooks, please. To add and subtract decimals, we line up the decimal points and then add or subtract. In our first example, we're adding 5 7/10 with 3 14/100. So our first step is line up those decimal points. Make sure that they are stacked on top of each other. Notice that the length of the two numbers are different. This one has 2 digits and this one has 3 digits. The important part is that those decimal points are forced on top of each other. What I notice is that there is a hole next to the 7, which brings us to step 2. Annex a 0 after that 7. We want to fill in the hole with a 0. That way we know there are 0 hundredths in 5 7/10. Our final step is to add. 0 + 4 = 4. 7 + 1 = 8. Decimal point, decimal point, decimal point, straight in a line. And 5 + 3 = 8. So 5 7/10 plus 3 14/100 equals 8 84/100. The same goes for subtraction. You line up your decimal points, annex zeros if you need to, and then subtract. Let's get into our books. On page 335 in your My Math book, we're going to look at adding decimals. To add decimals, line up the decimal points and add the digits in the same place value position. That means you only add tenths with tenths, hundredths with hundredths, thousandths with thousandths. That's hard to say. You add ones with ones, tens with tens, etc. Mr. Jacobson uses a digital scale to measure 44 2/10 milligrams of sodium for a chemistry experiment. During the second experiment, he used 33 1/10 milligrams of sodium. What is the total amount of sodium used? What do I know? I know he first used 44 2/10 milligrams, and in a second experiment, he used 33 1/10 milligrams. What am I asked to find? The total amount. Okay, that indicates that we're adding. We've gone ahead and done an estimate to make sure our answer is reasonable. We've rounded 44 2/10 to the whole number 44, and 33 1/10 to the whole number 33. So 44 + 33, if you can't do that mentally, you can stack it, is 77. So our estimate is 77 milligrams. To do this skill, we need to line up the decimal points. Notice here they are, stacked, one on top of one another. Now in this example, both of our add-ins were in the tenths, so we don't need to annex any zeros. So let's add. 2 + 1 = 3. 4 + 3 = 7. 4 + 3 = 7. So the total amount of sodium used is 77 3/10 milligrams. Let's compare it to the estimate, which was 77. 77 is about 77 3/10. They're super close, which means our answer is reasonable. Here is an example of how you can use a place value chart to help you add decimals. Let's take a look at the next page. You can annex a zero to one of the numbers in an addition problem so that both numbers end in the same place value. Find 19 6/10 plus 4 31/100. Our estimate for this one, 19 6/10 is really close to 20, and 4 31/100 is really close to 4. So let's round that and get an estimate of 24. To do the actual answer, we line up our decimal points. Bing, bang, boom. Now our original problem called for 19 and 6 tenths, okay? And you notice that we've annexed that zero so that they are the same length in the decimal place value. Now we can add 0 plus 1, 6 plus 3, 9 plus 4, and 1 plus 1. So we get 23 and 91 hundredths. So 19 and 6 tenths plus 4 and 31 hundredths is 23 and 91 hundredths. If we compare that to our estimate of 24, 24 is close to 23 and 91 hundredths, so our answer is reasonable. I am going to jump ahead to the book lesson on subtraction so that I can show you one or two examples. So in your books, let's find lesson 10. Okay, where we're now going to look at subtracting decimals, and that is on page 361. To subtract decimals, line up the decimal points, then subtract digits in the same place value position. So again, it's the same process as addition, which is why we can do these two lessons together. The table shows the average lengths of the three longest bones in the human body. How much longer is the average femur than the average tibia? Getting a little science here, I like it. So what do we know? We have to look to our table to figure out what information we have. We know the length of the femur, the tibia, and the fibula. What am I asked to find? How much longer is the average femur than the average tibia? So in this example, we have extra information. We need femur and we need tibia, which means the fibula is not needed. How much longer is this than that? That indicates subtraction. We're finding the difference. So we're taking the femur, which is 19 and 8 tenths, minus the tibia, which is 16 and 9 tenths. Our estimate would be 20 minus 17, which is 3 inches. Same process. Line up your decimal points. In this example, both of our numbers are in the tenths place. No need to annex any zero. Bing, bang, boom, there's your decimal points. Let's subtract. We cannot take 9 from 8, so you have to borrow. 8 becomes 18, 9 becomes 8. 18 minus 9 is 9, 8 minus 6 is 2. 1 minus 1 is nothing. So the average femur is 2 and 9 tenths inches longer than the average tibia. Subtraction and addition are inverse operations. Inverse operations are operations that undo each other. Okay? Addition and subtraction undo each other. What else undoes each other? Take a second and think about operations that undo each other. Multiplication and division. So let's use addition to check our answer. To check, we can take our difference plus the number that we subtracted, and we should get the original number. So if we take 2 and 9 tenths plus 16 and 9 tenths, line up my decimal points, nine and nine is 18, six and two is eight, plus one is nine. We get 19 and eight tenths. So when I used addition, I ensured that my answer is correct. On the next page, sometimes both numbers in a subtraction problem do not end in the same place value. Annex zeros if necessary, just like we did for addition. Find 6 and 3 tenths minus 4 and 78 hundredths. We've rounded to the nearest whole number to get an estimate of 1. When I line up my decimal points, and I write my numbers around it. 6 3/10, 4 7/8. I notice I have a hole, and that's when we annex. Okay, we have some borrowing to do here. I can't take 8 from 0. 0 becomes a 10. 3 becomes a 2. 10 minus 8 is 2. I can't take 7 from 2. 2 becomes a 12. 6 becomes a 5. 12 minus 7 is 5. Decimal, decimal, decimal. 5 minus 4 is what? So we got 1 52/100. Use addition to check your answer. 1 52/100 plus 4 7/8. Eight plus two is 10. 7 + 5 + 1 = 13. 4 + 1 + 1 = 6. Now be careful, this says 6.30, which is actually the same, because remember, we annexed a zero, so that is the same as 6 3/10. There are equivalent decimals, or decimals that name the same amount. All right, what I need for you to do now is to go back to the addition lesson, which was lesson 6, and start working on the independent practice and problem solving, and then you can go here to the subtraction lesson and work on that as well. Please make sure you raise your hand if you have any questions, and if you need to review any of this, you can do that at home or you can do that right now. Rewinding is a powerful tool. Have a great day, and I'll see you later.